the forecourt. Figure I'd give a random episode of my career game. I haven't really recorded these because I wanted to make another one and share it, but I haven't gotten around to it yet. So I'm gonna share this game. I'm glad I didn't record last game because we just lost to the Houston Rockets, man. I swear. Don't even get me started, but yeah. I play for the Brooklyn Nets.
Hey, sorry, man. I know it's right before the game.
This team is so high and cold,
okay, so
man.
Here's the deal really quick. We've got a bunch of people in the audience that we paid to take video of you and put it up on social.
Take video of me for what?
Okay, so here's the pitch. Totally don't have to do it if you don't want to.
It's easy.
But all you would have to do is put on this hat, make a half-court shot during the shoot-around.
I'm not going to make
on
it.
Social, and you get paid. Easy money.
Are you paid to do that?
Yeah.
Yeah, just make a half-court shot in the hat, you get paid.
I'm not going to make it.
Yeah.
I don't shoot threes.
For you guys, I'll do it.
Yeah!
There you go.
Give me the hat. Let's do this.
In the hat. Half-court.
My guy.
Got you. All right, good game.
Bro,
good
game. This video about to be dumb long because I'm not going to make a shot. I have a minute. This isn't even my home crowd. The hat kind of fresh though. That T-Pain on the. They booing me, bro. I don't want to do this in front of them. I got 30 seconds to make a half court shot. Ooh, come on, that was close. I am not going to make one. I shoot around by the end. Somebody pass me a ball. Bro. Oh, I'm not going to make it. Oh! I made it! That better have counted. Who that brother is.
Happy holidays, everyone. And David Aldridge is staying.
Well, Kevin Durant said his days of trying to prove himself through basketball are.
All right, thanks,
Yeah. I don't want to hear about KD right now.
Here's what the Minnesota Timberwolves have lined up on their schedule. On Wednesday, they'll take on Chris Middleton and the Milwaukee Bucks. And then on
probably
Thursday,
can't even hear what's going on because they're going to take out the audio.
The Golden State Warriors.
In that game against the Cavaliers, even though they should get the win, I would expect it to be a bit of a battle. Just
Nas
because
Reed.
They are favored doesn't mean it's an automatic W.
So the Nets starting five. Jackson is out there with Durant. Then there's Irving. Then
there's
Spencer Dinwiddie. And it's Jordan in at the five. And for Minnesota, the tandem at the one and the two.
Yoppers.
Teague and Culver. Then there's Towns.
He was
then
missing out all last game.
And it's Reed in at the power forward position. Couple teams now, Doris, slumping here in the middle of the season. How can they avoid lengthy cold streaks? The absence of
computer.
Yeah, I think this is where veteran.
That's all Gerald Green was doing to KD all last game, and he kept making it.
The course of a long season. This is the point when you start to lose games. You
I'm getting held by a point guard.
And splinter, and that is where that veteran leadership in the locker room, just to keep everybody unified, can be so critical.
I'm not a Timberwolves fan. I'm not a Jeff Teague fan. I'm not a Carl Anthony Towns fan. I feel like he got so much potential, but he plays so soft.
He's almost automatic. Boy, that's pretty good defense. Wow.
Lobs it up for Jordan.
That goes in. Wow.
Timberwolves have gone 1-3 for the field to start this one so far.
He's supposed to be like a player that turns a franchise around. They only been relevant when Jimmy Butler was there.
And here
they're
the first,
so
closing in
trash.
On 2 minutes play. To the wing right side. Six to shoot.
Here's Culver. He got me.
Connects from 3-point range.
and looking good there from distance. Culver fundamentally sound with his jumper.
And they'll always try to inbound me the ball. I'm a center.
Going against the Rockets in the last game they played.
You know what? That's a game where the coach might just want to burn the video, because there's no question they're a better team than what we saw, but they got crushed on that night.
They slept walk through that entire effort. Way too much talent on the roster for them to let that happen.
Here's T. Kevin Durant.
Oh, no, come on. Oh.
And last year, a tough one for Jeff T. Just couldn't put together his normal level of play.
I'm not a Jeff T. fan either.
Missed some games with injury, but his shot just wasn't consistent. His passing and playmaking were as strong as ever, but he just couldn't rely on
I hate how they could just click on you like that, dude.
And Kevin, this is why Teague is such a valuable player. You know, he's
pinned your shot.
Anywhere, so he's able to space the defense. He can, with his handle, get inside the paint. There's a lot to like about Jeff Teague.
Now, here's Culver, following the miss by DeAndre Jordan.
How does he finish that pass, though?
Rebounded by Jackson.
Well, they are daring him to miss, and he obliges.
Jordan at the elbow.
I'm playing that's point guard right now.
Jackson with the assist that time.
I hate that. They always finish those trash passes where they're about to make the layup, and they just pass out perfectly. Anybody could do it.
Teague against Irving.
I'd do anything slightly to resemble that. It's going in the backcourt, out of bounds.
High
great defense.
Shot, the rebound by the Nets. Right side, Irving.
There you go, Kyrie.
And he banks in the layup. Irving's got his second basket.
Am I Chris Paul?
Moving it around, eight of their last 10 coming off assists.
Culver passes to Towns. Here's Reed, shoots the three. The Timberwolves.
Thank God you got that rebound.
Can't hit.
Oh, we got it.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. Defense right on him. Two free throws coming up, and they call.
Had the lane too, but okay.
It goes on Jared Culver.
You know, when Spencer
bro, come on, yeah, always missing free throws.
Call. Simple as that.
And the six-six.
I can never go swish. I always gotta like rattle around the rim.
Of the Detroit Pistons in 2014.
I have so many complaints about this game when it comes to CPU.
One of the most improved players in our league last season signed that 4-year, $48 million.
Ooh, get that out of here.
The Nets rewarding his growth.
Hands with the ball out of bounds. Jordan touched it last. Towns kicks the tee.
Excuse me.
Shot clock at 5. A floater.
A real struggle to shoot the ball in that first quarter.
And it's Culver at the elbow. Walden with it. He's picked up by KD.
And they've done a nice job controlling the defensive backboard to start this game.
Ooh. And what? Yo.
And it's Jackson with the assist that time.
I got that break starter badge.
Kevin Durant.
And now you see
I've never seen KD this aggressive. He always playing soft. Kyrie, you should have won making crazy buckets.
Over Irving, the Timberwolves again can't hit.
Boy, with his shot not falling right now,
there you
it
go.
Might be time and to one. Look in a different direction. See if you can get your teammates started.
Their dribble mechanics be so BS too.
For a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. Nothing seems to be going his way this quarter.
Well, not at the offensive end, certainly. He cannot buy a bucket right now.
Now here's
there you go. Gave you that.
Teague able to get his shot to go.
I haven't shoot the ball yet. I'm having so much fun playing point guard.
It's come from inside the paint.
Outside, Walden. Here's Towns.
Oh.
Sinks the 15-footer.
I mean, guys, how good is the form and the release?
I think Towns has the ability, ability to be so much better than he is right now.
Dinwiddie outside. This is it to Durant. Jordan finds Jackson. Back to Jordan. Outside, KD. Brooklyn gets
good rebound.
With the new shot
good rebound, boy.
And there's Jordan putting it right back in.
It is not easy trying to keep DeAndre Jordan off the boards. His combination of length and determination, so impressive.
So the Timberwolves called their first timeout.
And after spending his first NBA decade with the Clippers, DeAndre Jordan bounced around last season. Remains a supreme athlete and rebounder, though, at that center position.
Looking at who's out there now for the Nets. Allen's checked in for DeAndre Jordan. Torian Prince comes in for Kevin Durant. And Caris LeVert subbed in for Spencer Dinwiddie. Here's Towns.
That was a block.
And the rejection by Jackson.
Thank you.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
Yeah, I'm about to have a double-double off so far, point, assist and rebound. Attack.
No doubt, Greg, hey, offensive end, it feels like they're getting the shots they want, and defensively, they are connected and on a string.
Here's Towns, after the basket by Brooklyn.
Wow. These are the things that upset me about this game.
Jordan, but some
go ahead, pass it, Mick. I know you're going to do it.
Last season. Greg, what was that?
Well, I felt like his impact has
tipped off. That was stupid. He kept doing that against the Rockets, just throwing dumb lobs.
Sometimes the great athletes have more of an adjustment as they enter.
Good boy, Kyrie.
A team's rebounding is a great measure of its energy, and theirs has been terrific here in the first quarter.
Up and under.
Here's Jackson. Now the pass to Allen. That's good, and it's Jackson with the assist that time. Jackson's got assist number 7 for him tonight.
Bro, I'm a point guard right now.
Napier passes to Wiggins. And it's sent back by Allen.
That was all Allen.
This guy is a sensational shot blocker. Jared Allen twice on the pipes.
And
bro,
that one's good, Irving.
I picked
how
a perfect game to record.
A possession like that from them today, ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Now here's Napier. Still getting warmed up offensively.
Get off
no
me,
scoring yet from him.
Splash.
And Kyrie Irving gets the 3.
Should have been doing this last game, bro.
Building up a big.
We went up big in the first quarter. Went down 15 when I sat down. Brought the game back.
The
Rockets just kept cheating.
Adjust, this could be a blowout.
And that one's good. Wiggins.
Go really smooth. Andrew Wiggins with the terrific mid-range.
Get another player.
Irving for 3.
Questionable.
You can't get that one. And it's the Timberwolves.
So much potential to be so much better than they are, but
coming against Cleveland in their last game.
Soft.
Yeah, but what a tremendous effort, Kevin. I thought they were coming all the way back. Such a terrific fourth quarter of basketball, but they just could not get over the hump.
We know this about Robert Covington. He is a team man first and foremost. Pretty pass.
Here's Irving. Out of bounds. Minnesota takes possession.
That's wild.
And just a fantastic run of games for
takeover
him.
Drains out so fast.
Player of the week.
And what can you say about how huge?
Of course,
he said
now when I use it. Well, I should be like 40-40 when I get back in the game.
Minnesota, they have shot 1 of 3 from the line tonight, missing 2 earlier on.
Close enough. They got a decent squad. I'm not sold on Jeff Teague.
And free throw, good from Jang.
And you think about the Wolves' history. KG clearly their best player.
I haven't scored yet.
Big Cat has a chance to reach that level someday.
He does, Greg. And I think we always look at KG's selection. Legacy being defined by passion, commitment, and leadership. That was as important as his basketball skill. Karl Anthony Towns is similarly talented, right? I think the key is he just needs to find consistency. That's the last.
He snagged it out the air.
Out there with Harris. Then there's Jackson. Then there's DeAndre Jordan.
Oh, I was trying to get that lob back door.
In at the 3.
My bad. That was bad spacing.
Here's Culver. Lays it in off the breakaway. Culver's got 5.
And the decision making proving to be outstanding. Culver just has a knack for taking advantage of the D in the open floor.
Big nose.
Switching on every possession in the NBA from a defensive standpoint.
I have to go dumb earlier.
The way Doris offenses are adjusting to that.
Yeah, I think number one, you have to attack the.
I'm tripping on camera.
And It's an interesting balance between attack
so
and
fast.
Patience. Because the one thing you're ultimately seeking in every switch is a favorable matchup for yourself.
That's get your butt in the post, KD.
Thinking guard who knows where to find and put the ball is so critical to your success.
That's a good way to look at it. Now here's Jackson. Tight defense on him. Somehow ignores the tight D and
100%
gets
smothered.
And the Nets lead by
I think
10.
About this game. They over-exaggerate, like, the defense.
Now, here's Colvin. Guarded by Harris. Pass to Reed.
My bad.
Jordan with the rebound. Jordan's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Jackson gets to Durant. And the rejection
I should have took that out.
Jane.
The 7-3 wingspan erases that shot. Nice by Gorky Zhang.
I'm back, AD. I shouldn't have put you in that situation.
Dishes to Zhang. Pass to Culver.
Ooh.
Teardrop
thank
shot.
Thank you. And it's grab the board.
KD. Jackson finds KD. Back to Jackson. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
I'm tripping this game. I usually have 16 points at this point.
They'll be matching up against Giannis Antetokounmpo and the Milwaukee Bucks. Then on Thursday, they'll be playing against Draymond Green and the Golden State Warriors.
And you know, nobody loves playing on the road, but it does offer a good chance to see exactly what your team is made of. This team is going to find out a lot about itself over the next stretch of games.
Here's Reed. That one wide left.
And I'm not sure that is a shot that he should be taking.
Well, it's hard to imagine that the play was designed to go in that direction. Boy, I'd be surprised if we see that again.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Kenny Atkinson, who's a native of Long Island, now has his dream job, coaching the Brooklyn Nets. He doesn't need praise or recognition. Instead, he's fueled by the fear of failure. He says, I always feel like I'm one away from never being in the NBA again. Kevin, he's got his team playing with that same determination.
David, he sure does. Thank you very much. Harris passes to Dinwiddie.
They always go away from the screen.
Outside
don't force
Jackson.
It.
Rebound how did Minnesota. He Towns has got rebound number 8 now.
One thing that bothers me about this game, like they be exaggerating their abilities all the time, bro.
7 points in the basket from Walden.
How about the record?
And my reaction time is always getting like sliced
when the defense has broken down.
Harris dishes to Jordan.
Oh. Run that back over here. Get to KD. That's Mouse in the house.
Here's Jackson.
But because Towns came over, that messed me up. Yeah.
Went right in terms of execution. He just can't get it to go.
Teague against Dinwiddie.
See that their dribble mechanics will get them. Oh, are you kidding? They just left right the whole time before until they get by.
He's not expected to be the scorer on this team that he once was.
And for Teague, to me, that is a blessing as he is much better suited as a distributor of the basketball. He's got great vision. He cut down on his turnovers, and therefore his assist numbers increased.
Looking at who's out there.
Kyrie, chill.
Garrett Temple has checked in for Joe Harris.
Oh, he dribbled into like 3 defenders and shoot.
Well, we know this. Kyrie Irving on any given night can give you 40 on the offensive end. What a special talent.
Minnesota calls timeout.
A career best season for Kyrie Irving in 2018-19. Scoring just as great.
I hate how they make you wait 5 seconds before you can skip this stupid timeout tab.
He made tremendous strides.
Out to the wing. Passes it to Culver.
Bro, why am I always so far off?
Off target from outside. Brooklyn leading by 7. And the Celtics expected Kyrie.
I lost the ball. They
should
be reaching. In
Boston.
They felt he had the capability. You could argue that those improvements have elevated him from a great.
Every shot I take, I'm smothered. I gotta chill.
maintain our lead.
And the pass to Towns.
We're about to say it.
T kicks to Walden.
All right, juke me down low. Get out of here, boy.
And the rejection by Jackson.
Never try to do that to me. Splash. He never makes it. He never makes it.
Minnesota's gone an even 50% from three-point range in the second quarter. 4 for 8 inside. Towns.
Swat it. You can block that.
Towns has got 12 points.
He got an 89 overall. I don't think he's that good.
Your head down after a tough
That's just me.
You've got to keep fighting, and now he's starting to roll.
Pass to Jackson.
I hate this play.
Kicks it to KD. Temple finds Jordan. And he's fouled.
Oh, why he fouled that?
Shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points.
Hey, but
the
he got the foul.
That one is on time.
And how the most of the time they force you to watch like the last 3 seconds, last 5-8 seconds of the quarter when you're on the bench. I don't care.
Not gonna go that time. And so it's the Brooklyn Nets ahead by 9 as the quarter comes to a close. They're pounding the ball inside.
Thanks, Kevin. Andrew, they shot the...
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
I'm a plus 9.
We played through the first half. Plenty of basketball, though, left in this one. You look at Kyrie Irving in this game, he has been everywhere.
And how about the amount he's contributing in the scoring column? Through two quarters, he has been terrific.
And one would expect that the defense made some adjustments at halftime, but he has the ability.
Like, look how Carl Anthony Towns was able to react like that, almost blocked
it. And the two, Teague and Culver. There's Walden.
Computer's reaction time is sick off the blocks.
And it's Reed in at the four-man position. So that's the lineup for Minnesota.
Don't do it.
Walden with it. KD's on him. The shot, no good.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
That boy, to have someone back there who can erase your mistakes. What a big-time asset defensively.
Here you go, DJ. Got the shot you needed, though.
Fast break. Here they come. Culver with it. Defended by Dinwiddie. Culver passes to Towns.
He got it.
That one's not going to go. Some solid defense.
They abused the pump fake so much. Assist. Crystal
blows.
There you go.
Bucket is good, and he'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
Hey, KD.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
Greg, you get so caught up in how great Durant is at scoring that you forget sometimes about his other terrific offensive skills.
You know, KD doesn't really get a lot of recognition for his passing, but he has fantastic vision.
How Charles Barkley say, dribble, 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 dribble. Man, Kyrie, you don't got to take the whole team all the time.
He double teams and does a great job of getting the ball out to open teammates.
Now, here's Culver. Dinwiddie covering. And once again,
yo, DJ, chill out. And then you want to pass me the ball?
Ugly start in the second half. They've missed their first four. They've got to get on track.
Pass to Jackson.
Oh.
Back to Irving.
Don't leave Kyrie open. Get off me, bro.
Teague against Dinwiddie. 4 on the shot clock. Minnesota with
it goes in and out every time.
Towns has got double-digit rebounds now in the game.
Oh, foul.
Never
mind.
Basket is good. Got it to go through on the contact, so a free throw coming up. A great opportunity for a three-point play. The Timberwolves shooting their 7th attempt at the foul line in this one.
Boy, when you think about the skill that Carl Anthony Towns has, and you realize he's just getting started in the league, his future is truly
all bro, pass the ball, man.
Career,
what do you think? Fadeaway hook shot.
The most skilled big men to ever play the game.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. And with the offensive tools set of Carl Anthony Towns, Doris, he could see MVP consideration in the future.
Well, what we know about Carl Anthony Towns certainly is that each and every night he has a major impact for his team. And consider, he's still growing as a player and ironing out some areas. But this guy is going to be a star for a long time, no doubt. He needs to look to try to drive inside and get going. That outside shot is simply not there.
And they're going to say defensive breakdown. Yep.
Second chance effort. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
You know, Carl Anthony Towns has said he wants to be considered the best player in the league. He's got the offensive game, the versatility, the length, the mobility. Let's see what happens.
And you look at how my player wind up to jump. Just jump, bro. Offense.
And it's doing box jumps. He really has the entire package for a big man. Back to the basket, facing up, playing outside or in.
I missed. Stop. Get out the animation, bro.
And the timing just not there on that attempted alley-oop.
Just a missed connection, and it happens. I'm sure they will go back to it if given the opportunity.
Nets leading by 10. Fringe finds Irving.
That's cookies, boy. Look, take him to the basket. Yo, Towns, this movement is too free.
And Greg, as you said, it's the skill level of Towns.
How fast he is.
His young age, it is so incredible.
Very capable three-ball shooter, but he likes backing you down on the block as well. You step back and
look at him.
What he can do for a team, and there aren't really any holes in his game.
Back to T.
Good defense.
Off the mark, had a chance to trim it to single digits.
I'll tell you, no matter what he does, he can't find his rhythm, and you get the sense he's starting to press a little bit.
Here's the floater.
What kind of shot contest was that?
The Nets lead is cut down now to just 8 on the basket from Culver.
And that attacking mindset. When Culver sees an opportunity like that, he just grabs it.
Jackson against Towns. Trying to get something going. Back to Dinwiddie.
We gotta go away from the screen, bro.
From deep three-point range, from beyond the arc, and then some.
Boy, the long-range work from Spencer Dinwiddie.
Hey, yo, coach, can I catch my breath real quick?
Former second-round pick has increased his range.
Teague can't hit.
Well, defensively, if you allow him to get this close, you're playing with fire.
God.
He just happened to miss that one.
KD could be cheating, like holding you so you can't go open.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
And what you love about his work defensively, the
look at that. Look at him, Georgia move.
Challenge and change shots without fouling.
Thank you.
Stolen by Jackson. There's a lob to Jackson.
Wow. Is it because of my fatigue?
Walden wide open. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
I ain't never been so open
what?
In my life.
He's not on his game, no doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally
you know
on him, but he has not been an asset for his team.
Well, that's not the guy you want guarding him at the rim. Just too much of a differential in terms of size.
Minnesota calls timeout. A lot of competitors in this league, Doris, and you've got to be that way.
Oh, coach, can I get a rest?
This level. And I know you have a list of competitors that you admire a lot.
It's those guys, Kevin, who have that insatiable desire.
The coaching is weird, too. Like, some games they'll start Dinwiddie at two guard. Other games they'll start LeVert. Like, I prefer y'all keep LeVert in starting lineup. He's a two guard, not Dinwiddie. And we have no point guard in the, off the bench.
And
oh, it's the wrong person.
Here in the fourth. Jackson dishes to Irving. The Nets working the ball around now.
Oh.
Harris passes to Jackson. The kick out to Irving.
Kyrie, shoot that. Oh, you went away for the double team.
And Harris wide open. He shoots. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist.
Well, catch and shoot. Is that
I guess.
Harris
good patience.
Specialty? I think it is.
Shutting the floor for the Nets. Allen is out there with Jackson. Then there's Harris. Then there's Irving.
Why are you double teaming?
Durant in at the three slot.
What's up with these matchups?
On the wing, A.W. Covered by Irving. Pulls up on the wing. And once again off the mark by Minnesota.
He is just not taking smart shots out there. A pattern he has fallen into tonight. Boy, picking Jared Allen, number 22, back in 2017 has paid off for the Nets. This guy has proven already in his early 20s to be an NBA-caliber starting center.
Dinwiddie's checked in for Harris. And Jared Allen grew up in the Austin area and played near his home at the University of Texas.
Yeah, Kev, just one season with the Longhorns. He really came into the league considered a project. But boy, his development is truly ahead of schedule.
Pass to Reed. Dinwiddie with the rebound. Nets leading by 21. Down low, Jackson. The kick out to Irving. Irving double team. Dinwiddie with
Take him.
Culver covering. Count that one. 6 points for Spencer Dinwiddie.
Getting it done on
doing absolutely nothing this second half.
In the score.
Well, what I love, Greg, is the energy they're bringing right now.
What are you blocking, bro? Get to the ball. Don't just jump to jump.
The combination of his quickness and soft touch around the rim really allows him to pull off shots like that. A lot of players don't have
the reverse should not be muscling
in their arsenal.
Give me the ball.
Allen finds Jackson. Kick should have to Dinwiddie. A shot. No
getting
good.
Boxed out, hug, screened by Jeff Teague. 6 foot garbage.
He's trying to help them extend this lead, but it's been a tough night for him individually.
And it's Jackson with the ball.
Ryan, don't stop.
It up for the Nets. They can look forward to the American Airlines Center after this game. They'll match up against Dallas. That'll be the third game of this three-game road trip. There's the pass to Dinwiddie. Right side, Jackson. That one falls coming off Dinwiddie's feet. Dinwiddie's got 3 assists now in this one.
Simply crushing it right now. So much more accurate.
I need one assist to get a triple double.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Towns against Jackson. In the corner, it's Dinwiddie.
I'm double teaming before.
Puts it up from 12. Again, the Nets for two.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
Teague bounce pass. Here's Reed.
Wow.
Brooklyn with the rebound.
He really tried to glitch me just now.
Jackson kicks to Dinwiddie. Second shot opportunity.
Are you kidding me? How did he get the rebound? How did I miss?
Outside, Towns. Pass to Culver. Outside, T. Now Culver. Here's Towns. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Towns has got 11 points here in just the second half.
Well, the body control of Karl Anthony Towns, just a terrific job to take the hit.
Irving kicks to Durant. Pass to Jackson. And Jackson throws it down hard.
And he might be small for a center, but boy, can he jump out of the building.
Minnesota making some changes.
That makes me mad when they say that. He may be small for a center. I'm 6'10", 280.
The Nets also changing it up.
Temple what planet is that small?
Allen. And it's Musa in for Irving.
Everybody goes 8 foot tall.
Of course, you and I were just talking about something Commissioner Silver said the other day about a proposed mid-season tournament. What do you think?
Well, I certainly think if they do move to a mid-season tournament, it's going to have real value for it to matter, to get the fans engaged.
I should have picked that. I'm being selfish.
So,
I'm being selfish trying to get a triple-double.
You're going to have two goals instead of one
championship. You couldn't finish against that nobody.
Maybe you want to win that mid-season tournament, too.
Here's Okogie. Plays it up and banks it in.
Well, defensively, to me, you've got to do a better job communicating once the screen comes.
Passes it to Temple. Nets passing it around. Here's Musa. Jackson down low, defended by Towns. There's Dinwiddie. It's good. Assist this time from Jackson. Jackson's got assist number 10 tonight with that last one. For Minnesota, they've gone 5 of 11 from the field in the fourth quarter. To the middle, here's Bates Diop, and the rejection by Jackson.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Well, how about that floor awareness by Spencer Dinwiddie, getting his guys the basketball in great spots.
The pass to Towns. Of course, it seems like Adam Silver, the NBA commissioner, is one of the most well-liked commissioners in all of sports worldwide. Why do you think that's so?
Well, I think great he defense. Was amongst the most important members of the staff of his predecessor, David Stern, who obviously oversaw the greatest growth in NBA history.
No,
NBA
I was not. What?
Global game. But Adam
I was
Silver
pointing to Dinwiddie.
He is a great listener, a great communicator, and I've said this about the NBA for a very long time. It is a league that is in constant self-evaluation process. It is always looking for ways to improve the league, whether that means organizationally or with the play between the
kidding?
Lines, and that's all you can ask for.
Picking up the game, because I get
mad. Minnesota making some changes. Gorgui Dieng comes in for Town. And here is Teague. And so it's Brooklyn easily grabbing this one. This one was over well before the final buzzer. The fans were waiting for something to get excited about, Greg, but they never got it.
They sure didn't. I mean, they just rolled. What an efficient performance at both ends.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast.
That shooting is about to be crawling.
Greg Anthony and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew. This is Kevin Harlan.
All that delicious VC. My last name is not Jackson, by the way. I'm just saying. That's just the last name I always use. The last time I played my player or my career, whatever, since like 2K 10 and 11. All right, come on.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
And welcome back to the studio here on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith in a moment to speak with our postgame guest who's standing by on headset near the locker room.
Hey, this is Kenny, man. First, I want to say congrats. Triple-double. Incredible night. But I'm curious, were you aiming for that? It was something you were aware of?
Jack, come on now, man. If I'm aiming for anything, it's for that quadruple double, man. How's that saying go? Aim for the moon, and even if you miss, you might land among the stars. Well, I didn't see a lot of missing going on now, man, not on our end. And no, I'm not serious about that quadruple. I'm just saying that our goals are a lot bigger than one's personal phenomenal nights.
Man, keep that quadruple in your thoughts, man. It might happen.
And, folks, that's it for us. Thank you for tuning in. Always our pleasure, although sometimes it's yours as well.
Shaq, what are you doing? Look at
your mouth. Ernie Johnson. Have a great night.
What'd my team chemistry go on? This game is so weird. Alright, well, that's my game, y'all. Oh. I said, nah, you're not finished yet. Alright, speed it up. Speed it up.
What a great guy. I love having him on the show.
Strong agree. Yeah. We should have...
Oh, we are done. Alright. Yeah, enjoyed that. Leave a thumbs up. Leave a comment. Y'all want to see more of my big man? Let me know in the comments. And I'll see y'all in the next.